So, we are looking at a Black Lotus reprint. It's slightly different from what you expect. These are reprinted for the Asia Vintage Championship, the Europe Vintage Championship, and the North American Vintage Championship. Now, they are oversized, meaning that if you've ever seen an oversized Planeswalker or something like that, it's kind of that size. So they're not tournament legal. However, it is still a reprint. I assume the back of the card will have Magic the Gathering. A lot of people are speculating what this means. Does that mean the reserve list will be reprinted? And the answer is yes. I mean, you printed the same size, right? In Magic 30th, it was the same card with a different back. That's a reprint. Here, we have a card that is larger in size, but with the same back. Now, these cards, in my opinion, are very beautiful cards, and they will be highly desirable because it looks like they're going to be very limited. I don't know if top 8, top 1, exactly how you win one of these cards. I don't play professional Magic. I don't know. But it is a reprint. Is it going? I mean, they push. No lawsuits. No one has sued. I think people are very confused about what a lawsuit looks like. When you file a lawsuit, it becomes public. It doesn't matter if there's a summary judgment to dismiss. It doesn't matter if there's any of that. Because as soon as you file, you get a number and it has a docket. And in law school, we learned that crazy people file crazy lawsuits all the time. That a lawsuit that is like mind-numbingly dumb, people will file, and we will learn about in law school. But every lawsuit has a docket number. And you know Magic players, they love that clout. If somebody like Rudy Chan were to file a lawsuit and they would get thrown out, he would still mention that he filed it, right? Maybe I will start a GoFundMe and try to sue Wizard of Coast under the reserve list. Because somebody got to do it. You got to try. At some point in time, you got to try, okay? Magic 30th came and gone. No one tried. No one sued. Nothing happened. You can sue in any state. It costs less than $250. The money it costs to file a lawsuit in America is just very nominal compared to the time spent. It would be very interesting to document a series, but I just don't have the time. I mean, it's just hard to justify the time. This channel is basically dying. My other channel is blowing up right now. It's just hard to justify spending the time on a lawsuit of all things. And I'm also in a lawsuit now. It looks like we're going to go to mediation soon after, like, it's been over 2 years, but it feels like it's been over 3 or 4 years because it's been that long since, you know, obviously there's arguments a year before the lawsuit and then lawsuit triggers, and now we're in this for a long time. I just had my deposition a few weeks ago. That was pretty, you know, that took a whole day. It was a 6-hour deposition with breaks, so it took the entire day to finish. Assuming that one is over and they're still doing super stupid stuff, yes, I will sue Wizard of the Coast under the reserve list. I don't think I'm going to win, but I'm going to try. Because the longer, like, how much can Wizard of the Coast push? I don't know. But they will continue to push, right? The only difference between Magic 30th, which is the tournament size card, but the back is different. And this card is just bigger. But the back will be correct. So how close can we get? We've done it two ways, right? We've changed the size of the card. Okay. We changed the back of the card. Okay. Well, the next card, theoretically, should be the same size as a regular Magic card with the same back. That's the only thing left. I mean, am I crazy? No, I don't think I'm crazy. It's the only thing left for them to do, in my opinion. So let me know in the comment section below if it's a good idea or a bad idea to sue them. Oh, man, it would be kind of crazy. I mean, the cost wouldn't be that much. I would just represent myself. So I don't think the cost would be all that extreme. And I've actually, in the Wizard Coast, the Hasbro legal representative is in Houston. So at least we'll have a conversation, I'm sure.